Okay, I a few weeks ago told John, hey, I have a great story for Offertory that I would like to share. And when I told him that, I did not realize the story would be two-part. So I'm going to share that today. The first part was, it was back when we were about to have that snowstorm, our only real snowstorm that we've had. And I was leaving work, and as I pulled off the highway, you know, super busy time, and pulled off to my exit to turn to my house, there was a gentleman standing there with his bags, you know, with a sign, and just visibly shaking, because the weather had already dropped. And he didn't have gloves on. And, you know, I, of course, don't know a story. I never have cash. I never have stuff prepared in my car. And so I rolled down the window and I said, I have nothing to give you, but I need to let you know you have to find shelter. You know, you have to find some place to go. It's about to get really cold. It's about to snow. And he said, yeah, that's, you know, what I've been told. And I said, well, you know, try to find some place. I said, going in towards Choctaw, there's not going to be much, but find some place to go. And so as I was driving home, I thought, you know, I just really need to stop and get him some gloves, get him a hat, get him something. He had a good jacket on. But so I drove into Dollar General, that was the closest thing. And I'm grabbing just some thermals and some extra caps and some gloves and just a couple things to eat. And as I'm driving back, because this was a few miles away, I kept thinking, oh, I hope he's still there. I hope he's still there so I can get him the stuff. And all of a sudden I thought, no, I don't. I hope he's not still there. I hope someone has picked him up, taken him someplace to safety, to shelter, you know. And of course I thought, well, I spent this money. And I thought, wait a second. My prayer is that this man isn't still standing there, you know, because of course I can keep the stuff in my car and find someone else to give it to. I mean, that's not going to be a problem. And so as I pulled over to that area, he was gone. So I hoped that he had found safety and some place to go. But it was just interesting, my perspective in hoping, oh, I've got to give him the stuff, it turned into, I hope that he has found a place. And I think sometimes when we don't have something to offer, we can always offer that prayer. We can always offer that hope for that person. So the second part of the story was that the next day, a couple days later, I was checking my bank account and I realized that charge I'd made at Dollar General had overdrafted me. And I thought, oh my gosh, you know, and then you got to deal with the $25 charge, and which, you know, I was like, oh my gosh, and how did I do that and stuff. And I was able to move things around. I felt stupid about it, you know, but I thought two things. One thing was how close we all are at times in our lives to an overdraft, to not making a bill, to not making a payment. You know, and I've talked before, hopefully we aren't close to homelessness, but there might be times that we have been or have loved ones that were. And so that was the first part of it. And then the second part is I really started to think about how I spent my money. You know, it wasn't what I was buying for that gentleman or for someone else that put me over. It was the Starbucks trips. It was the extra sweater, the extra cardigan I didn't need. It was, you know, the extra money to eat out. That's what put me beyond my budget, you know. And so I really reflected on that, and I really reflected about the fact of what do we spend our time and our money on. Those are the things that show what are priorities in our life. And, you know, we talk a lot about here that sometimes we can't give monetarily, but we can always give a prayer. We can always, you know, grab the snack bags and hand those out. We can always give of our time coming up to help to get the church to our new location. And so that is what I bring for Offertory today. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for the blessings you've given us, the breath of life every day, the warmth of our homes or of our friends and loved ones around us. And I pray, God, that we realize those blessings, and in our journey to be more like you and to be the people you call us to be, let us look at what our priorities are, look at where we spend our time, where we spend our money, because that is a reflection of our desire to be more like you. In God's name we pray. Amen.